Okay, now for the second part of the program, let me just say a few words about what we have in store for you. We have the moment that you've all been waiting for. For 2 days, you've heard all kinds of case studies and discussions and debates on what are some new trends in ICT 4D, etc. On your way out today, you will all get this book. Somebody has already leaked some of it on WikiLeaks, so some people have already known who the winners are. But this book has a list of all the finalists, which is also on the website. But the website doesn't have the list of winners, which is in this book, which you will get on the way out. Okay, so be prepared for this, a very good list of winners, etc. My name is Madan, informally known as one of the three idiots, or rather one of the three bald men, myself, Osama, and Rajnesh, wherever they are. So that's us. And now let me invite three other distinguished people to join me on the stage. Ms. Delhi, Ms. Noida, and Ms. Gurgaon, will you please come up on stage and come on this side. Yes, so they're going to help me give away some excellent awards for all of the winners who've gathered here from around South Asia. There won't be many speeches here. You've heard enough speeches all year, all day for this day and the last day. But I will just say this, we are now at a very interesting month. This is December 2010, the last month of the first decade of the 21st century. So let's just spend a few minutes looking back at how far we've come in the last, say, 10 years. 10 years ago, roughly around the year 2000, what were some of the hot trends? Y2K, nobody even remembers Y2K now, but 10 years back, it was one of the hottest things going around. You know, what's going to happen? What are some doomsday scenarios, etc.? The dot-com boom was the other big trend 10 years ago. All kinds of young companies with CEOs who didn't even know how to maybe do calculations, but getting billions of dollars to run all kinds of startups. But beneath all that hype, there was some very good infrastructure, very good ideas which were implemented. Let's go back 15 years. August 15th, 1995 was a very significant year. That was the year when commercial internet access was launched in India. There were other kinds of networks like NICnet and ERNet before that, but commercial access through VSNL was launched on August 15th, 1995. And 8 days later, on August 23rd, mobile telephony was launched in India as a commercial offering. Can you imagine how any of us in this room could survive without the internet or the phone just 15 years ago? It's unbelievable. It's so much a part of our daily life that we take it for granted and we can't think of functioning without it. But think of all the other 95% of people in South Asia who don't have access to this fundamental human right, as was mentioned very well by Mahabir Pun yesterday. So this award ceremony recognizes and awards those who are pushing the frontier of the digital revolution and bringing more people into the divide, across the divide into mainstream society. We are very happy that this is the 7th annual Manthan Awards. I've noticed that many companies now, many organizations who have won the Manthan Award in the past, now mention it in their press releases. It is now on their website. We were the winner of the Stockholm Award, the Manthan Award. So we're very happy that the Manthan Award has reached that kind of stature. We also are very happy that we have not just the award ceremony, which is going to be in the next couple of hours, but we also have this two-day event where we actually bring the innovators, the startups, along with policymakers, along with educators, along with academics. I've been to many conferences which have only startups, only academics, only government. But this is one of the few which actually tries to bring about some kind of a dialogue on a regular basis, on an annual basis. So I think we're very happy that we're ending 2010, the first decade of the 21st century, with this particular annual awards ceremony. So those of you who are tweeting away this event, please use the hashtag #Manthan. I know those who are finalists are all waiting to find out who is going to be invited to come up on stage over here. First, let me invite our judges to stand up and be acknowledged. We have had a very distinguished jury this year. We have about 15 judges. Not all of them are here, unfortunately, but let me ask each of these following jurors to stand up and be acknowledged for the excellent hard work they've put in to judge these awards. First of all, Ashish Sanyal from DIT. Where is Mr. Sanyal? Please, a round of applause for Mr. Ashish Sanyal. Jaya Chitur. Where is Jaya? Yes, at the back. The smartest people in the world come from the back benches, but no offense for the front benches here. Who is ahead? Praveen Pannu. Is Praveen here somewhere? I saw her in the afternoon. Okay, she's not here. Rajnesh Singh, the other third bald Indian man. Well, he's around somewhere. Saman Subramaniam. Mr. Saman Subramaniam. Okay, he's not here either. Rajan Varga. I did see him a while earlier. I guess he's out having a coffee. And last but not least, Tulika Pandey. Is Tulika Pandey also here? Anyway, a round of applause for all of these judges. These are the ones who have judged each of these categories. So we now have 15 categories. Okay, so we're going to get started with our 15 categories of winners. We have the list on the various slides that you've seen so far. We're going to start off now with e-agriculture and livelihood. So the first category is, okay, e-category, but before that, let me just run through the jury film. Sorry, thanks Osama. So I'll run you through a brief video now, which shows who the jurors were and how this whole process was conducted. So let's have the video.
Ah, yes.
We are very excited that this setup here has been extremely smooth.
It is good that the Manthan Award now captures developments in the entire region.
We reached a landmark of 434 valid nominations this year.
Innovation is organic. It comes from the grassroots. Recognizing this, the Digital Empowerment Foundation launched the Manthan Award in 2004 to encourage innovators who use technology to deliver services to South Asians at the bottom of the social pyramid. Awarded annually, Manthan stays true to its name by recognizing pioneers in 15 different categories across the region. The awards are decided by a grand jury after a rigorous examination of the nominated projects that stretches for several hours.
This time, more than 330 nominations have come, and it's also a fact that from 11 categories, now it has gone to 15 categories. And because more nominations are coming, it is possible for the DEF to really subcategorize them. It's also a good trend. And the quality of nominations are also good.
This year, the large number of jurors, all experts in their own fields, account for the high quality of the winners.
It's a good mix. It's a good mix of academics, professionals, researchers, activists. The jury process is also rigorous because every nomination actually goes through at least two people. And probably will go through another round of discussions before it's finalized. So it's both anonymous and it is also rigorous.
The juridical process has matured over the last 7 years, and so have the projects that have been nominated.
We got about 22 jurors discussing for 2 days till midnight who could be the best winners. Some of the observations are that some of the new innovations are coming from the neighboring countries more than India, and India is getting into the phase of consolidation and replication and scalability. Lots of projects that we are seeing now is not looking very new, but they are looking at a different scale.
Another noticeable trend is the way this year's nominees have experimented across various platforms.
I think that technology is changing, there's more mobile coming in, cross-platform is happening. I see a lot of open source applications here come in. Radio also, a large amount of radio has come in this time. So I think that mix is there, but it's from the nomination itself, you know that the volume is growing.
What also emerged was a variety of suggestions, both for the nomination process and the projects themselves.
Everybody in favor of AP Online, please raise your hand.
Once implemented, they'll help adjust the juridical procedure to the changing nature of nominations.
So I think there are areas where we have to make conscious effort. In other areas, we have come to a level of maturity of the application. So we might want to actually predefine criteria for application itself.
The future is inclusiveness. The future encompasses both content distribution and creation. And the future is right around the corner. Manthan is all about bridging the digital divide and drawing more people into the knowledge economy.
Entertainment, culture, tourism, travel are still, and science are still the most weakest area where we haven't got much nominations and quality nominations. So we are going to work very hard to see that how we can get good nomination in that area and also create a good message across the country and the neighboring country so that we get good nominations.
Manthan has long been active in encouraging a movement across South Asia for creating digital content for development. And the increasing scope and quality of nominations show us the way towards a more inclusive future.